I'm Neelam Singh. I'm a trained gynecologist and I've been practicing for nearly more than 25 years now. I got interested into this issue, female feticide, way back in 90s when these machines, technology, ultrasonography, they started pouring in the country, especially in my city when they started coming up. There was a lot of requests from the patients to know the sex of the child in the womb, and if it was found to be a female, they were not willing to give birth to a female child. So that was the time when I thought of doing some organized action. Experience is that it's because of women, exactly, many women exactly don't want it, but you know the kind of society they live in and the kind of pressure they feel from the family, from the husbands and from the larger society, they are bound to think that they have to have a son in the family, not carry the lineage of the family, and they do not earn from for the family, and there are problems in the security of girls, and probably parents have to pay off a big fat dowry to the girl's marriage. These are the reasons why the families do not want a girl child in the family. They initially come to get the sexing done, but then ultimately they are convinced and they do not get the sex determination test, and they produce happily the girl child also, even if they know, they produce happily. So I think there I feel that the counseling is a big role. But I would say that it is very time taking because I have to spend many visits, I have to give many visits to these patients, and then finally they agree, and most of them they do not agree also. Yeah, personally I think I was very fortunate to take birth in a family where the values were almost similar for boys and girls, but still I used to feel these gender biases because I was looking into other families in the community. So I realized very early in my life when I was just 7 and 8 that these biases are there against girls, and even at that age and when I was growing up, I thought of empower myself to the extent that I could really hit hard on these biases. And I think that probably is the instinct within me which forced me to make this organization. I have to let other girls of my age group and other ladies of my age group enjoy the same liberty and same opportunities that I have enjoyed in my life.